Hi, today we are going to learn how to create a calendar booking system in WordPress. CM Booking Calendar allows you manage and display multiple calendars with open spots for visitors to book. In this example use case guide will cover how to create a calendar, edit it, show it on your site and then manage bookings. You can have multiple calendars in your site. Each has different availability and time slots. Only the admin manages calendars. Users can manage calendars via the User Booking Calendar add-on. Calendars are the core of the plugin. Let's see how to set up one. Step 1. Create calendar. Navigate to CM Appointments Booking Pro – Calendars. The list of previously created calendars appears on the right. On the left you can see the Add New Calendar form. It has many fields to help you tailor the calendar to your needs. Fill out all of the required fields for the calendar. Name. Type in the name of the calendar that will be displayed on the front end. Slug. You can write it or leave it empty, it will be generated automatically. Description. The backend description of the calendar, but some themes can display it on the front end. Notification email. The email for the manager of the booking calendar who will receive notifications of bookings made. Event duration. Choose how long can be calendar events that may be booked. You can tick the option offer multiple event duration to allow multiple options. The minimum time is the one set in the event's duration drop-down above. If you choose this option, the value in the previous option will be ignored. You can choose minimum and maximum time before booking. These two options affect the calendar. Booking spots. Set how many spots each event has. Change available time zones. Allows choosing time zones that will be displayed on front-end calendar. Ignore DST. Enable it to ignore daylight saving time. Automatic booking. Checking this box will set each booking as accepted automatically, meaning booking manager's approval is not required for new bookings. Hide time zone drop-down. Check it to hide the time zone selector. When you enable it, you need to choose the default time zone. You can now click the Add Calendar button. Step 2. Choose availability. For each defined calendar, you can set the available days in the week and the hours per each day in which appointments can be set. You can also set the days which are closed for booking. To set the calendar availability, navigate to the Schedule section in the plugin admin menu and choose the calendar you want to set or change the availability slots. On the first tab, Week Template, you can see the schedule grid. The grid displays each time slot of the week. Available slots are marked in blue. First of all, adjust the schedule grid granularity to the session length period to make sure the granularity of the schedule matches the session length set in the calendar setting. You can then mark the days and hours in each day in which booking is available. Note that you can select a series of slots at once with the mouse. The plugin allows you to configure exceptional days when the bookings will be available despite any other setting. This is done via the other two tabs. Head to the Days On tab to add days and periods that will have available spots despite the week template. Conversely, the Days Off tab allows you to set specific days that will be blocked despite the week template. This is used especially for holidays. If you add the same period as two days off and days on, it will count as days off. You can show calendars on any page by using a shortcode. The following shortcode will result in a calendar. Inside the calendar attribute, you should write down the slug of the calendar. If you have forgotten the slug, go to CM Appointments Booking Pro – Calendars. On the right-hand side, the existing calendars are displayed. The third column of the table displays the slug for each calendar. You can also access the edit screen of a calendar to find on the bottom a handy shortcode ready to be copied. Navigate to a previously or newly created page or post where the calendar will be shown to site viewers. Then paste the shortcode into the page or post content. It will result in the calendar. The plugin includes the ability to hold a discussion per each appointment request. You can start the discussion by heading to the Bookings menu and then pressing the Discuss button. It will open up the form to send the discussion notification to the user. Clicking Send will notify the user. You can edit the notification email from the Notification tab in Options. We will consider it a little bit later. Each booking has a separate space for discussion. It's a single page which changes depending on the relevant booking. The user will receive a link to this page from the email notifications. Once clicking on this link, the user will see the discussion form which let him respond and view all previous discussions related to this booking request. How this page works. Once the plugin is installed, a new page is created by the plugin. It includes a short code for the discussion. You can further edit this page to add or remove content. This page is pointed in the plugin options under the plugin options tab. There are some ways you can improve the calendar visually. Head to the options menu. You must know that these settings apply to all calendars. Inside the plugin options tab, you can customize the general aspect of the calendars. First day of the week defines which day will show first on the front view of the calendar. View of the calendar. The default view of the calendar. Day, week or month. Small screen mobile max width. Input a number in pixels. If the device screen is smaller than this number, the view will be changed to day by default. If you set it to zero, the screen size will not be taken in account. This setting improves the mobile view, as the day view is smaller and therefore best suited to smaller screens. Search for an open slot. Defines within how many days range calendar will look for an open slot when the user loads the calendar. Setting a high value might cause a slowness in calendar load in case the calendar is busy. Send email reminder before appointments. Setting 0 disables the option. Display booked slots on calendar. Choose yes to display the number of available and total spots for each event. If the event has an opening and the user has the relevant permission, the plus icon will be visible. Clicking on it directs the user to create an event from the backend. Show email in booking title. Adds the user email to the name of the booking. You can see this in the booking's dashboard as shown. Show time zone in booking title. Allows you to see time zone on booking title. From name and from email. Type in the name of the sender and type in the email where the notifications will be sent from. Discussion forum page. This is a pre-selected page which is generated once plugin is installed and includes a shortcode for the discussion option. You can change this page while selecting another one. Also in this setting you can enable reCAPTCHA by adding a reCAPTCHA API side key and API secret key. It's recommended to reduce potential automatic spam requests. Next step, email templates. Email notifications are essential, so don't forget to configure them. You can configure automatic emails for different situations to the admin and to the user. You can edit each notification email's subject and body. Placeholders are important parts of the notifications. Similar to shortcodes, they change the content depending on the booking. You can see the samples on the screen. Translating the plugin's interface. You can change the text of the front-end to anything you like. To do so, navigate to the Labels tab. The plugin settings enable changing any label used on the front-end. This includes also messages and labels which appears on the calendar. Calendar colors. Inside the Appearance tab, you can change the calendar colors of many elements. Use the color picker to choose each color. Recounting bookings. You can manually recount bookings by heading to the Recount Bookings tab and clicking the relevant button. Recounting bookings is useful if, for some reason, the counter does not change when a user rejects a booking. Improving the booking form. When a user tries to book a slot, they will be automatically directed to the calendar's booking form. By default, it has the fields Select Duration, Email and Notes. We'll cover over here how to customize the form. Navigate to CM Appointments Booking Pro Forms. Select the calendar that you would like to make a contact form for. The form builder will open and the form can be modified as you need. Click on the desired field on the left and a few moments later it will appear in the draft form on the right. To rearrange form items, they can be dragged and dropped into whichever order is needed. Each field can be marked as required so that users cannot send the form without completing them. Fields can be given a placeholder default value. Fields can also have short description added to help customers progress through the form. For some fields such as email, phone number, email, it may be helpful to add validation to ensure that the required information has been added properly. You can also use radio buttons, checkbox and select box as part of the form. Once saved, the form will appear in the front-end view when the user tries to book an appointment. Form information is saved in the appointment post which is accessible from the booking dashboard. It is also represented in the placeholder, which can be added to any email notification sent. This is a good opportunity to add terms and conditions information to a required field. Following the instructions found in the plugin and guides, you should be able to manage multiple calendars on your site. Thanks for watching the video!